I'm pretty convinced that people really like what I eat in a week and what I eat in a day videos. And because of that, I gotta give the people what they want. I am back this week with another what I eat in a week video. And I'm actually sharing 9 different things that I ate this week and I loved, which is the only reason why I'm sharing it with y'all. Because if I didn't like it, it would not be in this video. And I tell y'all, this dairy-free ricotta jam toast little situation is my absolute favorite. I mean it, like it's just something about the flavors. It's giving what it's supposed to give. I first found out about this via Nicole with More Salt Please. When she posted it, I was like, you know what? I have got to try that. And once I tried it, y'all, I was hooked. I went to the farmer's market and found a mango habanero or mango jalapeno jam. As you can see, y'all, I was literally eating on this every day, which is why the jar is pretty much empty, because it's so good. I started to get a little fancy, add a little fresh basil. Listen, I'm about to go make some right now. I'll be right back. No, I'm just playing, but it's that good. Next up is a barbecue chickpea and kale slaw wrap. Y'all, when I tell y'all it's so good, okay, I know I say that all the time, but I really mean it. These barbecue chickpeas are absolutely amazing. All you have to do is simmer the chickpeas in barbecue sauce as well as vegetable broth and some little seasonings, and it is so good. Simmering the chickpeas in vegetable broth as well as the barbecue sauce really helps them from drying out. Like, sometimes you don't really want dried chickpeas unless you maybe like eat them as a snack. So I decided to whip those bad boys up as well as this slaw, which has kale, cabbage, and then you saw me mixing together. It was a little bit of vegetable broth, some barbecue sauce, some vegan mayo, and I believe I used garlic powder, onion powder, and some salt. Look at these chickpeas, like absolutely amazing. So I added all of that to a wrap. I topped it with some vegan cheese, some red onions, as well as some jalapenos. Now, I know I say I don't like too much spice, so this was the right amount. I chose the smallest pieces as possible. And then also some avocado. Listen, now I've never worked at Chipotle, but these are wrapping skills. Impeccable. I mean, I could have did a little bit better on the cutting, but still, that's besides the point. Look at that. And as a snack, I have been loving mangoes. And if you're like me, you like to put tahini on your fruit. Like, it's just something about it. It's so, so good. And normally when I post this on my Instagram, people always say, you forgot the lime, you forgot the lime juice. And one time I did, and it was just too sour for me. Another day this week, I did not have these in order, but another day this week I had this ice cream cookie sandwich and it's really good. And I picked this up at Whole Foods. Alright, so I'm calling this one a breakfast skillet only because, so it was shakshuka inspired, but y'all, I don't think it was by any means traditional at all. I tried my best, but it ended up being really, really good. One day I'm going to find a very authentic recipe to make at home and truly enjoy traditional shakshuka. But for now, this is what we have. So I started off with some onions, some bell peppers, kale, mushrooms, and I had some leftover tofu that I was just like, girl, throw it in there. And that's exactly what I did. So I cooked that down a bit and then I added in some tomato paste as well as the last bit of harissa sauce that I had. Y'all, this sauce is so good. I was down to my last. I added some water in the jar because I was like, no harissa paste left behind. Okay. For my seasoning and spices, I'm using cumin, I have onion powder, garlic powder, smoked paprika, some dried parsley, as well as cayenne pepper. Mm-hmm. Next, I added about 3/4 cup of water so that I could let this simmer and kind of let the flavors from the vegetables and the seasonings and the spices blend together. And I completely forgot to mention that I had roasted some sweet potatoes to add in here as well. Y'all, this thing is loaded. I told you, it's loaded, but with a bunch of good stuff. So I wanted to wait and add the salt at the end after this has simmered a bit, just so I can have a better and true idea of the flavor and how much it needed. And another ingredient, I added in some fresh tomatoes. This by itself would have honestly been great over like some brown rice or some white rice. So the next time I make this, I might save a little bit of the mix to put with my rice for dinner. You see me pouring in the vegan just egg, and I am really trying to channel that shakshuka. So I covered it with the lid and let it cook down a little bit until the vegan egg was fully cooked and ready to be eaten. And this was so good. I actually ended up taking it to go because I was short on time, and I had it in the car with some tortilla chips. Y'all, fire, okay? Fire. So here is what I'm having as a snack. I love buying these, and so I probably buy them like every week, honestly. They're so good. This is the cocoa almond crunch. They also have like a, I think it's like a key lime, but this is my absolute favorite, and I get it every time I go to the store. So this one is like super quick. It's actually not very special, but I wanted to show y'all how simple meals can still be very delicious. So I made a little quesadilla using these burrito wraps that I found in my local grocery store. Added in some frozen kale, onions, and mushrooms. And the cheese that I'm using is by Field Roast. It's their tomato cayenne cheese, I believe it was. I enjoyed that with some dairy-free sour cream as well as some salsa. This day, it felt so good not to have to cook. We went to a restaurant here in Arkansas, and I was able to get me some vegan sushi. Any idea what this is? It is lion's mane mushroom. Y'all, this is the perfect mushroom to make vegan crab cakes. I told y'all, this is a mushroom stan account. Now, these can sometimes be hard to come by, so I would recommend checking out like your local health food store or farmer's market, because a lot of local mushroom growers are producing lion's mane mushroom. And we're actually gonna bake these in the oven for a small amount of time, but first we are going to kind of doctor these bad boys up. So I added in some olive oil. Now I'm adding in some furikake seasoning. And next you'll see me add in some Old Bay. And now we are making the crab cake mix. So already in my bowl, I have some vegan mayo as well as some green peppers. And you just saw me add in the Old Bay, some dried parsley. Now I'm adding in the furikake and kelp powder, which is completely optional. And y'all, I'll have this full recipe in the description box as well if you want to give it a try. And so this is flaxseed egg as well as some panko crumbs that we'll add into the mixture after we add in our lion's mane mushroom. And so this is a dish that you have to let marinate for a while. So I always just stick it in the refrigerator overnight. But before putting it in the refrigerator, here's a little tip. I like to wrap my vegan crab cakes in seaweed because the seaweed gives off an of the sea flavor for the crab cakes once we make them the next day. Or if you want to put this together earlier in the day and then make it late at night, that's always an option as well. And this recipe will give you about 4 crab cakes all together. Now, if you make them bigger, you can probably get like 2 to 3. You make them smaller, you can have as many as your heart desires. So at this point, we went to sleep and now we're awake and we are finally making our vegan crab cakes. So I'm just mixing together some panko crumbs, some Old Bay, and kelp powder. Here are the vegan crab cakes after they have marinated for, I would probably say, at least 8 hours if you do want to give this a try. And now we're just gonna dip those bad boys in the panko breadcrumbs. And I cook these on both sides for about 2 minutes, and then I'll add them into the oven. And I'm having these with the salad only because this was literally the only thing I could think of. It was quick, it was easy. I was tired of cooking at this point, so a salad it is. And so I also made like a little sauce. I think I used vegetable broth, some Dijon mustard, capers, hot sauce, a little bit of lemon juice, and maybe like some salt and pepper. And it was so good. I actually ended up eating the third one. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. So good. Well, y'all, that is all that I have for this week. Be sure to leave me a comment and let me know which of these meals you plan to try. I will see you guys next week, same time, with more amazing vegan eats.